the total mass of a matter being exerted with gravity. Itu masuk dia, itu masuk weight tu. So dua benda beza kan, that is two different thing. Okay, so when it says that its weight is also an important factor, meaning that the weight with and the mass with the gravity effect, okay, being exerted upon it, or said that that is itself is also is a force, a load. Okay, so a particular rod, as an example in figure, this figure one, if you look, okay, that needs to be decided on its material, has specified length of L, meaning that the length itself is already been specified. Okay, dia dah tetapkan dah panjang, the length is already been specified, and the load is fixed at F. Okay, there is also a load. Okay, and the architect needs to decide a lightweight material. Okay, it wants a lightweight material that can achieve both objectives, meaning that they can achieve the specified length and also its force that being applied on it. It doesn't the rod doesn't fail. Okay, so based on the information, we need to translate the information and construct its translation table. Fill up the information on the translation table 1 in result 1. This is an example. So you're not putting it here, you're actually putting in result 1 here. Okay, so if I ask you, what is the function of this? What is the function of this? Anyone can answer? Tensile rod,
actually. Boleh tak?
Good, tensile rod. If your classmates yang dah buat lab ni dengan PM Zul, you, some of you maybe know the answers lah. Okay, tensile rod. The objective, actually terbalik sebenarnya. Concern kat atas ni, saya silap. What would be, okay, we start with the constraint. What is the constraint? Anyone can give me? What would be the constraint? Anyone can give what would be the constraint based on the information given here? Just this text only. You just refer to this text. What would be the constraint? Apa dia punya, meaning that the limitation that we want for the tensile rod. Anyone? Anyone? Apa limitation? What is the limitation? What is the constraint? Ingat dia bakal semua ni? Ada ke tidak ni?
So kalau yang material specified length tu constraint je bukan eh?
Yes, that is a constraint juga. Meaning that it's already, because some of you mesti dah previously took the subject, for example, for example product design, okay. So a building ke atau any structure ke apa, mesti ada the dimension that they already put in. Okay, you set in a dimension, specific length, specific width, specific area. Okay, so oftentimes that is a constraint. Okay, oftentimes that is jadi constraint. So you can put here length L specified, or you want to say fixed, or fixed length L. Anyway, can be. Anything else? Apa lagi? What is the constraint? Apa yang boleh fikir? Based on this text. Kita tengok balik. Based on this text. What would be the constraint? Ada lain?
Load, sir.
Sorry?
Fixed load.
Fixed load, yes, we can put that. The load is fixed. Okay. Right, sorry, go. Oh, okay. Fixed load F. You can also put it. Okay. Anything I have to begin? What about the objective? What would be the objective?
To decide lightweight material.
Okay. Lightweight material. Anything else? No. Anything else? Other than lightweight material, free. Ada satu je objektif. Biasanya objektif pun can be either one or two. Okay, in this case, so actually just one. If you want to put lightweight material, as I say, its weight is important. Lightweight material. Okay. Or you can put here pun nak kata, just as I already talked about mass just now. So you can put in minimize. Minimize mass. Can be accepted. Okay. Minimize mass. And the field variables, maksudnya apa, what are the variables, what are the, apa boleh ubah yang kita bebas, we can you choose freely. What is the
choice of material.
Okay, good. Choice of material. Meaning that any kind of material that can meet the constraint, that can that is lightweight, can sustain a fixed load, then we can choose the material. Okay, we can choose that specific material. I mean, then that is that is what we hope to achieve lah. Okay, okay. So done one result. Okay, and then next, now that the translation table has been filled correctly, and we have understood the objective, we must next find the material indices for the required design. Figure 2, okay, shows a diagram on how the tensor rod will be loaded. Okay, this is a schematic diagram on how it's being loaded. There is a force applied with length here. Okay, so after determine write the equations and determine the material indices. Okay, ini kita nak buat. You can refer to lecture on week 3 and 4. Okay, kalau tengok kat tu, to determine the equations and material indices in result 2. Okay, so this nak kena buat sikit equation. Okay, you have to make a little bit of equation. Nampak ya? You can see this is the for tomorrow's lecture. Okay, so I'll show you straight away what it mean by the material indices. Okay, this is an example. This is as the same example as the lab sheet. Okay, the tension rod is being applied with the difference is that it's being shown like this lah, as opposed to like this. Okay, so this is the area and the load, okay, with a specific length and also must not fail when applied with the force F. Okay, this is the translation table. Okay, it's the same. Okay, so how do we arrange the equation? Okay, as it says, we start with the objective. Okay, I'll make it clearer in our lecture nanti later tomorrow. Okay, it requires for a requirement for lightweight cylindrical rod or tensile rod. So we know the equation for mass is density times volume. Mass, sebab because density is mass over volume, so mass is density times volume. And the volume, okay, is area, the area times length. Okay, so we know that. So applied tensile load F must not exceed the material's sigma F or failure strength. Okay, must not exceed that. Okay, or tensile strength, you can say that also. Therefore, force over A, the force being applied, the stress being applied must be less than the stress of the tensile strength. Okay, so re-energy equation 2 gives A is must be larger than the force over the tensile strength. And in inserting equation 2 into equation 1 here, we will get sort of a mass must be larger or same as force times the length times the density over tensile strength. Okay, this is the third equation. And this equation is the, we call it as the performance equation. I'll explain a bit more later in our lecture. And where F is the functional requirement, okay, meaning that it must with this equation is that the tensile rod must be applied with this load F, and it has a geometric requirement which is L, a specific length with applied load F. And the final part, okay, if you look, this is this final part, we call it as the material index or material indices. Okay, this is what? Okay, call it as the material index or material properties. Okay, this is what it means. Okay, so okay, so this is what you need to write here, the equation. Okay, you have to write the equation there. Okay, you can follow the step by step on writing the equation in the material index, so you put it here. So the material index that we got, okay, when we say, okay, let me show you again. Everyone see this equation, eh? Nampak equation ni, eh? Okay, now let me ask you. If we say we want to minimize mass, nak kurangkan mass, F dengan L ni fixed. The force is fixed, the length is fixed dah. Tak boleh ubah. Dah specific dah. And we say choice of material, though this is what it means by the choice of material ni. This is part the material index or material properties ni. This is this part that we can play around or we have the freedom to choose. So if I ask you, if you want this value to be as minimal as possible, serendah yang boleh for this particular product ni, particular tensile rod ni, must be as minimum as possible. F is fixed, L is fixed. Okay, so how about this part, this equation part? Dia, how would you, maksud saya, what I mean is that how we want that value as what as possible, as low as possible, as high as possible, so that we have this this value M minimized. Can anyone answer? So boleh cakap. If we have F is fixed, okay, L is fixed, and we want this value of M as minimum as possible. So how about what does happen with this index here, this part of this equation? So boleh cakap. Kita nak serendah yang mungkin ke setinggi yang mungkin? Anyone can answer? Saya boleh jawab? Kalau saya panggil nama, if I ask, I call out a name to answer, Hazira Ifah. Ada tak? Hazira Ifah ada? Huh? So ke pergi makan sekejap. Anyone, apa tu Valentino? Adakah?
Low sir, rendah-rendah. Value will be low.
Be as low as possible. Okay, correct. Because we have fixed F, our length is fixed. So this part must be as low as possible so that the mass as is minimized as possible. Okay. Okay. So meaning that so we have here. So this this index must be as low as possible. This is what it means. Eh, to maksud dia. Okay. So apa tu? Though apa tu we say is minimized, okay, but in our design term, okay, kita tak kata macam dia, okay, because even though this FL ni kita dah fix dah, so we can't change, okay, and we say okay this must be as minimum as possible minimum, but kadang tu in design term, in actual practical term, we often we don't say this is must be as minimum as possible this index, okay. We say it must be maximized. It must be the term is often preferred to kita kata. We say is maximized. Memang. Sorry ya. Okay, sorry. Even though we say that okay, we want the mass is minimized, okay, minimize the mass. But we say when design term, okay, we don't often say okay, we have to really minimize the material property. No, we say we want to maximize it. Okay. Sorry, yeah. We want to maximize it. Okay. So M ni memang we want to be as minimum as possible the mass. So in usually in design term, this part, okay, this part here, we say we want to maximize it. How? When we say maximize it, is that we invert it, okay, we invert it, okay. So when we invert it, it will become this one, okay. So this is what it means. In practice, it is preferable to find the maximum value. So meaning that in design, okay, practice, it is preferably we say that we want to maximize this. So we want to maximize, in order to maximize it, maksudnya the this term, we just invert the material index. So we just daripada from rho over sigma f, the failure strength or the tensile strength, we invert it, meaning that we say that we want the value as high as possible, but we invert it, okay, it becomes sigma f, the tensile strength over the density, okay. The objective still the same, okay. Boleh faham tak this part ni? Siapa-siapa tak faham? Boleh faham tak apa maksud saya bila kata memang the minimum mass is minimized, but the material properties we want it to be maximized in practice, in secara when we say in terms of kata kita jarang apa tu people say maksudnya macam okay, contoh macam ni a car, okay, a car that needs to be fuel efficient, okay, a car needs to be fuel efficient, so we say it must be lightweight, okay. But when you say when you actually in production or you were say in design early on in the stage of the project itself, you often say sometimes you hear engineers or designers say we have to maximize the ratio of weight of the weight of the how much load being with the total components being considered, we have to maximize the area, we have to maximize. So you often hear that, okay, so that's why I mean that we invert this. Okay, the index instead of we say that we want to minimize this, so we want to maximize the ratio of the tensile strength over the density. Boleh faham tak? Ada siapa-siapa nak cakap boleh faham ke? On that
boleh
part?
Boleh
eh? Okay, boleh eh? Alright, you can submit to understand eh? Kalau tak faham nanti just anytime you can just interrupt me. Actually, our session we don't have to macam be formal tunggu saya tanya apa. If at any point you don't understand what I'm saying ke atau macam ada confused apa, you can just interrupt me anytime. Okay? Okay, so then this is the material index here. Okay, so if I paste this, nanti question you have to write in the report. This is the material index. Okay, so then how do we nak buat material index tu? Okay, let me share first. Stop here. Okay. Okay, so kalau tengok. Tutup pula. Okay, so we've already done the material index. Next that we already determined, okay, you need to construct the required material property chart in using the software. Okay, so saya stop dulu sini. Apa tu share ni? I'll share my screen. Okay. Now this screen eh. Okay. So I'll open CS Edupack. Okay. So dah biasa eh. Some of you already done last lab and everything. So we start with level 2. Choose level 2 here. Okay. So before you start using this, okay, make sure first you set the preferences according to what we be using. So you choose tools options here. Okay, so you go to units. Okay, you can change the preferred currency here. If you want to put USD, no problem. I personally would prefer Malaysian ringgit, so then we are more comfortable, so we know it's actual we it'll be easier for us to understand, okay, how much material cost and everything. Preferred unit system, make sure it is you can put SI, consistent, or metric. Either way is the same, okay. You can use metric system. Metric is SI, just as SI is more accurate in the standard, okay. The SI is more metric is just that metric, meaning that the standard materials, standard units of you can use either one, no problem. Okay, don't use other units, then you'll be more confusing. Okay, so either metric or SI you can use. Numbers you can choose, no problem. Either you want to use scientific, engineering notation, so no problem. Okay, so number of figures usually put 3 significant number. Okay. Yeah, that is the stand. That is the often the normal practice. So apply and okay. So okay. After that, so we've already done this. Okay, the already set up. So we start with select. Okay, we want to select the material. So it says selection data, the database level 2. We select from which one? Level 2 with durability equal. So basically we just start with the level 2 material ni bahas on it's enough. Excuse me. So then we choose graph. Okay, over here we have y-axis and x-axis. So as you so if you look here, this is sigma f over rho. Now, if I can't remember if I did. Didn't show. kat sini tak? Okay, this is actually a lecture note for next week, but I'll show you anyway. Okay, so if you see here that just for this example, okay, change this to symbol to sigma. Okay, let's say so our index is M sigma over rho. Yeah, this is it. Ini kita punya, nampak eh? This is our material index. Okay. So, sigma is sigma over rho, our stress over density. Okay, if you look here, okay, if I choose here sigma, mechanical property, y-axis, eh? You tensile strength, x axis would be the density. Okay, this is the graph that we get. Okay, how do we get? How do I know I want tensile strength as y, density as x, as opposed to maybe not density at y or tensile strength is in x? Okay, so how do I choose that? Okay. If you look here, okay, then I change this symbol. Okay. This one. Okay, so we have stress, okay, equals to material index M, okay, because we got this M is equal to the material index is M, M equals to stress over rho, okay, yang ni eh. So if we change the, we put the main as the stress equals to the material index times rho. Okay, if we change this in, because this is an equation with the value is a large value, meaning that if we put in, let's say, the exact value of stress, we get a very large difference a graph. Okay, maksudnya apa yang saya cakap ni, maksudnya macam persamaan ni, this equation, okay, kalau kita cuba grafkan dia, dia akan jadi macam bentuk slope. Okay, because the value is very large, is incremental. Okay, dia memang dia numerical value makin tinggi, makin tinggi, makin tinggi. Because stress, because for example, cawan saya ni, okay, maybe dia pun it's tensile strength is just about maybe what 3 pascal or maybe of 10 pascal for example. Okay, this glass cup. Okay, but if I have something like for example, this is a solid this battery is a solid carbon steel. Could be this solid carbon steel is tensile strength is about 10 megapascal. Megapascal meaning that to the power of 6. Okay, nilai tu it's 10 million times as opposed to 1 million times as opposed to this cup. This is 10 pascal only. This is 10 megapascal, which is about a million times difference in strength. Okay, so imagine that. If I put in plot, if I put exact value of that, I will get sort of a slope because of this this equation. Okay, because of this equation sebabkan apa tu nilai apa tu ingat kan apa tu if mathematical equation, okay, the number of the value of let's say okay it's value if its difference is large you will get a slope because of the equation itself how it function, okay, dia akan nampak macam slope. So it'll be difficult for us it'll be easier for us if you make it into a more linear slope, okay, a more linear graph. So that's why we're taking the log of the number. Maksudnya kalau katakanlah because this is only 10 pascal and this is only 10 megapascal, for example, the strength 1 million, but if I take a log, it's actually just 6 times only. Faham eh? Faham tak maksudnya kenapa log tu? Kalau hacanya guna, if I use or the exact value, I will have a very large difference. But if I just use only log, meaning base number 10, I only have, this one is actually just point, let's say point, 0.00, depend on the minimum value, let's say this is only about 10, and this is only about 6 times. So the difference is much lower. Faham eh? In the graph itself. Okay. So changing it to log, we have log sigma equals to log rho plus log n, because something that is being multiplied in log is just it, we have to just addition only. Okay. With the base number 10, log is base number 10. Something that is being multiply, when you change it to a log equation, it becomes only addition, okay, penambahan saja. So then having this, if we change it into a linear, then we can have a more linear equation. So we have here log sigma equals to log rho plus log m. Ini kita akan dapat sini log m. And if you look here, if we because they are the same, it's the same characteristic as a linear equation. So we have this as the y, okay, and this as the x. Ini log rho ni as x, and h is the log m. So y log rho, x log y log sigma stress, x log rho, and h is log m. So y is the y axis, and then x the density, log density. Okay, so h ni apa? What is the h? Anyone can answer? Apa itu h? In linear equation, kalau linear equation. Plus h ni, h is the what? Masa boleh jawab? Siapa saya nak tanya lagi ni? Okay, Syauki dah jawab dah. Kata slope. Yes, correct. Eh, slope. Salah. Yuji. Yuji ada? Yuji? Chan.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so h is the what? What is h?
Intercept.
Okay, right. Ada kat sini pun. Intercept atau h? Intercept. Okay, intercept. Slope ni m ni equals to 1. Sebab apa? Sebab ni tak ada. Walaupun if I don't put in the number here, but we know something that is, it is not, unless it's a different number, but usually kalau people tak tulis apa-apa, maksudnya satu lah. It means one. Okay? So you know already that. So, maksudnya this equation, okay, this our equation ni, if we change it into log, okay, then we have y as the tensile strength, density as the x-axis, and our intercept is m here, and width 1, slope dia. Okay, so we already got this one. Dah dapat dah. Ni kita dapat first ni apa semua lah. Okay, this is our. Okay, that is the graph. Eh? Okay, so next it says here determining itu berdasar dari required material property chart. Okay, so dah dapat dari material property chart. So this one, so you just screenshot here. And then just paste in result 3 here. As simple as that. So you get the property chart. Okay. Next, now we call animity with the requirements of M. Actually, M.002 ni actually mega PSI. Salah. Or 8.6 MPa. Tesla. 0.2. Okay. Using the gradient line selection or slope, list the candidates that are met that are metals. Nak kata metals available for selection is out 4. Okay, dia kata dia nak the design is metal. Now metals ini, and it must be apa tu with a minimum. Minimum Tesla strength 8.6 megapascal. So choosing here, okay. So if I use this option, family envelopes, tengok sini, you get this. Okay. If I highlight this one, ni dia, this one, metals and alloy. So we want to choose this red colored materials. The yellow one, what is this? What is this? Are just ceramic. So we don't want the ceramic. We want the metal. Okay, so kalau tak nak label tu ada tu, jadi ya, nak macam mana nak label tu datang, just klik saja ini dia akan keluar label. Tu je label keluar. Okay, if you don't want the label anymore, just delete. Just click on delete and you will. So we want to choose this. Okay, mana dapat tu tekan kat sini eh. Dekat envelope ni. Okay, so dia kata the gradient line selection or slope ni kat sini. Nampak ni eh, this is gradient line selection. So choose here, enter slope. So you know the slope is 1. So just click OK. Click anywhere you want. Just click anywhere you want. Akan keluar. This is the line. Okay. Okay. So. Apa tu distracting the. Okay. So. If I highlight this line here, okay, and if you look at my bottom, I'm looking in front of me is bottom left. I don't know if you are actually facing the same arrangement, okay. If you look at the bottom left, if I move the line here, if you look on the left. Okay. Okay. Nampak tak sini? Nampak tak dekat ni? Saya gerakkan line, ada nampak tak macam X berapa, Y berapa tu? Slope satu, nampak tak? Anyone boleh confirm tak nampak tak on the?
Nampak saya nampak.
Ya, okay, nampak gerak tu kan? Okay. Actually, point itu 1-1-1-1 ni. Jadi silap saya. Sekejap. Saya patutnya 0.86. Okay, so just move lah. 0.86. Okay. Oh, okay, my mistake actually. Okay, my mistake actually betul lah. Oh, saya itu saya buat ni lah, saya buat I think last time I did using a different graph. I think this is correct. Okay, nanti apa tu, I'll upload this ini. Kenapa? Okay, this is actually 0.2. The intercept is 0.002 megapascal. So you put here. Okay. Sekejap saya delete dulu dari sebelah. Line 1. Just ni. Okay. Masa saya letak line ni mula-mula. Okay. Now, if I ask you. Okay. We want the material minimum must be maksudnya dia punya kita, it must meet requirement intercept 0.002 megapascal tensile strength ni. If it's higher, meaning it's good lah kan, maksudnya kalau dia, if it's the strength of material is more than 0.002 megapascal, meaning that the material is good. But if it's below, is it bad? Betul tak? Kan it maknanya macam dia tak meet lah. Okay, so we want to choose material yang above that value. So if I, there are two ways you can do this. You can either, if you want to choose material the above this slope ni, you just click anything above it, dia akan jadi macam ni. Maksudnya nampak tak tadi, nampak tak sekarang jadi grey dah. Meaning that if I move this line, if I move this line, ni, anything below it, anything below that line is turning to grey. Maksudnya dia dah tak meet the requirement. Anything above this line is meeting the requirement. Okay, look what happened if this line, okay. Cara menit itu, there is one thing. If I again buat lagi line ni, and I click, masa baru first time letak line ni, the first time I put in the line, the slope. If I put click in below, you see anything that below the line is being grayed out, meaning that we don't want any material that is above this value point, above this line lah. Kalau kita gerakkan, if I move it around, anything above is being turned into gray, anything below is still in colored, meaning that this is the material that we want to choose. We can do this, either we can use this, or okay, saya letak balik, okay, or we can use options, we can use tools, options here, okay, and then selection. Selection. Wait, ada ada selection kat sini. Tak ada. Okay, I don't know why. Cuma tak ingat dah kenapa. I can't recall why. If I remember correctly, memang ada. Okay. Okay, this is what. Saya sorry, not this one. Okay. Yeah, the function is bukan kat sini, eh. Okay. So if I okay, kat sini. Kita jumpa dah. Okay, already found it. Kat sini. Okay, this is the gradient line kita. So if I right click here, right click at this part here, edit stage, selection. Okay, this one I can choose dulu, kerana saya boleh ubah. Either saya macam saya buat cari function, saya just macam saya first time I put in the line, the first time I put in the slope, the gradient line, and then the first clip, if you put click above that line, it will choose anything that is above that line, that it will be what it means by it meets the requirement. If you choose below, if you click below, there will be you will see the color being turned. Anything that below is being colored, or you can set here manually. Saya tukar sini below. Ada gaji macam ni. It will be like this. So if I at this stage, I choose selection again above the line. Turns out this. Okay, two method you can use. Okay. So we want it at least 0.02 megapascal above. So you choose 0.2. Nampak kat, if I move here, nampak kat sebelah kiri bawah tu, you can back at the video, change it to 0.002. Yang paling dekat lah. Kalau tak dapat, ni, that is the best I can do lah. 0.002. Okay. Or you can just edit the stage. Sorry. So you can put in. Yeah, if you calculate, tapi this is much harder, okay? To calculate, it's just easier if you just because of course you can use log x log y, then kira dapat 0.02 the intercept. So if this is it'll be much harder to use to calculate manually. So just use the manually, you move the line manually. Okay. So we got it. This is 0.2 kat sini. Intercept 0.02 megapascal, and anything so we will choose that anything above this line, meaning that we anything that is above the intercept. And usually it says it what matters only. The requirement is that only it won't it just we want to use matters only. So from here we put we click on 3. Okay, this next step we put in 3. Tekan click on 3 here. Okay, this is 3 stage. This is the option keluar sini. So we see that you only want metals only. So highlight metals here. Click insert. Okay, select metals only, and then click OK. Okay, so these are metals only that is according to the requirement. Okay, ni lah material dia. 28 material that pass our ni. So then we just put here. So you just go back to the ni. So just either you can ni saja pun cukup enough. These are metals that we meet the requirement that we have. Ada 24 types of metal that we need. Okay, next. Says here, if LA is given 50 mm squared and the loop you need to stand is 50 mm, the length is set at me. So its weight must not exceed 100 kg. Select the candidate or method that can fulfill this requirement. So how do you proceed this? So you have area, okay? And you have a load 50 kN. So then you can calculate the stress. Okay, the stress has been applied on the material. Kirakan force over area dah ada dah. And then length itu dah set at 200 mm. its weight must not exceed 100 kilogram. So you can put in the requirement here. Okay, calculate the load. Okay, sorry. Okay. You can choose Okay, you can put here density berapa? Okay, because we have area, we have the length, so we have volume, and we have the weight, so we know density. So you must not exceed, meaning that that is the maximum. Okay, with this, so you know then the density is what. So then also you can put in the sustain without even, so minimum is that the stress is must be, so you can put in here the tensile strength. Okay, the minimum is how many megapascal minimum, and then you can okay, so ni you can do it on yourself the calculation, and then bila dapat contoh, this is just an example, this is an example, I didn't calculate it properly. So for example, I put in the tensile strength minimum must be 100 megapascal, for example. Okay, click on limit. Okay, so just apply. So I have here. So for example, the maximum density, maybe I put in the calculating, I got maybe about 5 kilogram. Oh, way too much. To maybe, I don't know, 3 kilogram over cubic meter. Oh, that's good. 1 kilogram. Okay, tak cukup lagi. Let's say 0.5. Saya pula 0.001. Tak cukup lagi. Oh, sekejap. Oh, maksimum. Paling lah. Because metal is about 10,000, okay. So let's say I put in 5,000 maximum, then around this value. Okay, so itu, this is just example, right? But it means what I want you to do is that you have to calculate by yourself here. Calculate according to this value, seperti ini. Density you can calculate. And then the area, and then the stress you can calculate, so then you get the nanti dapat. See. Okay, you can much, so you can narrow, and then you will be narrowing it down the selection. Okay, boleh. So just bila dapat tu, so just paste. Okay, paste, and then you get the answer. Okay, so the child will be able to find the result is in the appendix. Okay, so that is all. I think it's already about an hour plus. Okay, 1 hour already explained. Boleh faham? Takkan ni untuk this lab sini, lab practice ni. So you just do what I roughly shown you, and then complete it, and then you can submit it by latest is tomorrow lah, last day. I give time. Boleh faham eh? Ada soalan tak? Any questions?
Okay, sir. Boleh.
Eh? So you can do it. Ada anyone any have any questions ke? Ada sesiapa ada soalan on getting the material index ke nak dapatkan tu? Anyone? Semua dah install eh? Apa tu ni?
Sir, nak tanya yang calculation tu? Dia kira dalam CES, dalam software.
Masuk kamu?
Maksudnya calculation tu kira by apa CES lah, pakai software lah. Lepas tu
tak, no. Tak. Ya, kamu you can you what I mean is that you have to calculate how much maksudnya the stress sneezing without yielding and the density must not exceed tu apa tu the maximum density. So calculate, you can calculate calculator or Excel apa semua, then key in the value here. Masuk kat sini, kat limit ni. Okay. Maksudnya first stage tadi kita start dengan this graph. Okay. Dah dapat material index with the slope and everything. So then we use stage 2 which have, then we create this line ni. Then we set at 0.2 kat sini. Kan the intercept at 0.02 megapascal sini. And then we set the stage 2 is that we want to choose metals only. So kat 3 sini kan we choose dari metal ni tadi. Stage 2 ni, stage 2 only show metal. So any other material kita dah ignore dah. We don't want any other material, we only want the metal. And lastly we key in we calculate stage 3 ialah kita calculate this lah, this stress and density kita nak kena masukkan. We calculate it manually and then we key in inside here, then we apply, then we choose finally this is what we left this. Ni kita ingat. Ni faham eh? Itu je stepnya. Ingat ni yang saya letak ni jangan buat kamu tengok ingat balik kata mencet tak 5000 jawapan ni tak. Ini saya contoh, this is just an example. Okay. This is just an example, so you have to calculate by yourself. Boleh eh?
Okay sir. Boleh.
Okay. Anyone else ada, does anyone else have any questions? Anyone else have any questions you want to ni? Ask me? Siapa dia? Ada no. Soalan?
No. Huh? No.
Assalamualaikum apa eh? Okay, so if you have any questions, okay, thank you very much for your time. Okay, so I hope you help with this lab tadi punya ni. Okay, so first of all, I think my apologies for the interruption just now because of suddenly my PC restarted and everything. Okay, thank you for staying for a while. Okay. And, first of all, I'd like to thank you everyone, okay, for spending your time with me about an hour with this lab session. Okay, even though you feel that it is obligatory, but at least you still spend, you're still willing to spend.